guys, my name is Claire Holiday. Some of you may know me from my book and writing oriented channel on YouTube, but today I wanted to start a new series about creatures that are both terrible and mystical from Celtic lore. Today we're going to be looking at the Cat Síth, which some consider a fairy, a phantom, a witch, mostly from Scottish lore, but has been known to show up in Irish as well. Cat Síth is Scottish Gaelic that literally translates into cat fairy. While the general consensus is that these cats are much larger than a typical domesticated or even wild cat, either the size of a large dog or even a small calf, that are all black except for a big white spot on their chest. But some sources say that they are in fact indistinguishable from domesticated cats, except when no humans are looking at them. And then they rear up on their hind legs and walk around two-legged. Sometimes they're even spotted wearing human clothes. So there are two specific lores or legends surrounding the Cat Síth, and neither one paints them in a particularly positive light. They are generally seen as tricksters and are disliked and distrusted by mankind. The first one involves them being soul stealers. It was believed that when someone died, their soul still hung around their body and would sometimes take a few days before the gods snatched it up, and that if the cat walked over them or near them, the Cat Síth would literally steal their souls for themselves. Special watchers or guards were employed to guard the dead bodies to make sure that the Cat Síth didn't come near. This would involve them literally using catnip, playing music, telling impossible riddles, and this generally leans towards that the Cat Síth have a fairy background and that these games and riddles are enough to distract them. The other notion or legend was that the Cat Síth were actually witches and that they were transforming from their human witchy selves into these giant cats, but that they could only do it 8 times throughout the witch's entire lifetime. If they were to do it a 9th time, they would be stuck in the cat body for the rest of their lives. This is where a lot of researchers believe the phrase "cats have 9 lives" may have originated from. During the celebration of Halloween, which originated in Ireland and where they believe that the veil between the living and the dead was the thinnest, people would often put out a bowl of milk for the Cat Síth as an offering. Should the Cat Síth find it, they would consider it a treat. Should a household not put out a bowl, they would trick the household by murdering their livestock. Some modern researchers believe that this legend may have originated from these large Scottish wildcats called the Kella cats, which are technically a mix of domesticated and wild. But while most wild cats have a tabby texture to them, the Kella cat is distinct for being an all-black cat. So that's all for today's episode. I'm going to be focusing the series mostly on creature lore. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave a comment and give this a big ol' heart if you enjoyed the series, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye!